Oh, snap.
Finally, a Titan direct drive and linear rails for a budget price.
I'm not really sure what this is. It was taped to the outside of the box, but I will see. Oh, at least we got something to print with now. So there it is, it's out of the box, and it's not quite as big as I thought it was gonna be, but that's okay. If you remember this right here, it's the largest thing I've ever printed in height-wise. So I don't really think I'll need to print something like this again. I did this one for fun. The widest thing I've ever printed is right here. It's a little splat for plugs on my wall in my shop. I thought it'd be fun. So you'll see, I really don't think I have the need for a large print surface. What I'm gonna do next is I'm going to put this thing together. I'm gonna time it and I'll let you guys know how long it took and if I had any issues. So without further ado, let's get cracking at it. So this thing comes about 95% complete. It took me exactly 4 minutes, 39 seconds to put this thing together. Now I don't know if it's put together right, and I don't know if it's gonna work, and we're gonna figure that out. But that's pretty darn fast. All I had to do was put in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 screws, and then this lead screw right here, and then tighten down 2 other screws, and I was done. So this thing comes with a bunch of spare parts and even has nippers. I've never gotten another 3D printer with nippers. And I like having extra parts handy just in case I screw it up. The build surface is 200 by 200 by 200 millimeters. And this thing comes with options that larger, more expensive 3D printers don't come with. It has a Titan direct drive printhead, linear rails. It comes 95% complete. It's extremely quiet because of the stepper motors. It can print PLA, flexible materials like TPU and PETG. But the last 2 points I want to make are very, very important. So listen to me close. It is very compact, so it'll fit in any shop, and the price point is below $200. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to level the bed, then we're going to print a benchy. The first thing I do when I'm going to level a bed on my 3D printers is I loosen these all the way up and until they do that, and then I just go back a little bit. And I do that on all 4 of them. Now I'm not going to make you guys watch this because that's just silly. I'm going to level the bed. If I have any troubles, I'll come back and I'll tell you. So I'm tired of making that same old benchy, and they have on here, it's a little chess piece, and I don't know what they call it because the dang stuff was in Chinese. So I'm going to go ahead and print up this chess piece. As I was trying to print this, I kept on getting an alarm, and then I realized I forgot to install the feeder tube here that goes to the drive, and then the filament sensor, I didn't even know it was right there. We'll talk about that at the end of the video. Well, here's the chess piece that I was talking about that I was gonna do. And I'm gonna tell you what, there is one little issue and it's right inside there where there were no supports. This thing printed beautifully, and I don't know what to say. This thing, that was a first print, and it was this good. There's no stringers, no issues with the layering. Whew, this makes me want to print something else. The great thing about 3D printers is you can be as fun and whimsical as you want. You can download from Thingiverse or a dozen other sites, or you can make stuff yourself. I choose to download my stuff, but I want to make some stuff for Thanksgiving since I'm having a lot of people over, and I want it to be a little bit fun and whimsical in itself. So I found some napkin ring holders that say gobble gobble on them. So I'm going to print those out. So there it is, this one's done. I think this file wasn't that great to begin with, but you can see it, that's kind of cute. And those little, the little napkins will go right through there and it'll say gobble gobble. I think it'll be kind of cute. The next thing I'm gonna do is make some knobs for my CNC. It'll be for the hold downs and a bolt will be able to go through them so it'll tighten down real good. So you saw this thing print, and I see this, but this was all support, about as much plastic as used for this knob. I didn't need to make it this big, but that's what
you're now doing. That we've done the napkin rings for Thanksgiving, I think I want to focus on doing a couple of ornaments for my granddaughters to paint and put on their tree.
Unfortunately, all I have is this glow-in-the-dark filament right here. But they can paint that just as easily as they can white.
So I'm not really sure what has happened here. I left this last night to print that snowman and I came out and nothing had happened. And it looks like it's tried to push the filament down into the drive, but it didn't go. Now the tip's getting really hot and everything's getting hot, but now this is stuck into this drive. So I'm gonna have to take this thing apart and see what I can do to get it out of there. Now granted, this is some older filament and it does feel a little bit dry and it's glow in the dark. And let me see if I can fix this and then I will be back.
There's a piece down in there now. It's in the center of that piece right there. All right, we need to take this little piece off here because it's in this tube. And there it is, that's where it's stuck at. Have to figure out how to get that out of there. All right, I just poked that Allen wrench through it and it popped right out. So let's get this back together. I'll be right back after I get it together and we'll see if we can run it.
Okay, I got it all done up and I'm hoping that it works. We will see. There it is. Little snowman. It's kind of cute. It'll make a little thing and I'll have my granddaughters paint that. All right, the next thing I'm gonna print is an ornament, another one for my grandchildren. And what it is basically a frame where they're gonna put a picture in it and then we're gonna glue it all together. I think it'll be real fun for them.
Well, it's jammed up again.
So I figured it out. Okay, I didn't figure it out. I gleaned it from information that the team over at Kingroon and on a video that they had talking about this issue. It was my extraction settings. I had it set to a 1. There are tests that you can do inside Cura, download and install these plugins, and you can do towers and all that, and I have not done that. All I did was set it to 0.5 from the 1,
And we're gonna do a test print and see if it clogs up again. All right, because what happens is, this is your filament and it goes down into the hose and it comes out the extruder right here. Well, what it does is the extraction brings it up so it doesn't clog up and keep oozing out of your nozzle. But when it's set too close, it continues to ooze out of your nozzle. If you set it too large or high, it sucks back up into the heat resistant tube. And when that happens, the hot filament expands inside that tube, and that's where you get it to get stuck. So hopefully this has fixed that issue. All right, the final print is done. I decided to do a little keychain thing, and it's just a fist that turns into a middle finger. Isn't that cute? Just, I don't know. I thought that was a cute little thing, and I wanted to see the retraction is working great. It's perfect. I had no stringers or anything, and it looks like it's a very good print. So, boom. We're done printing. Let me tell you what I think about this machine. All right, time to discuss the things that I feel could be different or changed to make it better. And I'm by far not an expert at this, but I don't like the filament sensor on the side of the machine. I wish it was up on top here and they had some sort of mechanism for the filament to be on top of the machine and go directly down into the Titan head. So when I first got the machine, this arm was not level. I don't know why, but I had to loosen the screws and screw it back in and level it, and it took me a little while to do that. Didn't like that the filament was getting stuck inside the Titan direct drive. That was my fault. Now, for the things that I thought were good, that they don't need to improve on, or whatever you want to call it. Number one, they have linear rails. This gives a much stabler and better movement of the X and Y axis. I love it. The SD card right here on the side. Love it. Easy access, nothing keeping you from getting that card in that slot. This thing is extremely compact. I'll be able to keep it up on the shelf and take it down whenever I need it. It took me less than 5 minutes to put this thing together. That is a huge selling point. So lastly, the price point for this machine is under $200. It's actually on sale for Black Friday right now. I think it's somewhere like $189 or $186. You can head on down below and click on the link to go check it out. Overall, I'm gonna give this machine an 8 out of 10, just because I had issues with the print head, although they were my own fault, but I'm still gonna take away those 2 points. I would highly recommend this machine. So if you're in the market for a compact sub $200 machine, the Kingroon KP3S PRO may be what you're looking for. All right, I appreciate you stopping by. If you could, head on down, hit that thumbs up button and share the video. Head on down to the comments. If you have any experience with one of these, tell us what you think about it. If you want to, hit that subscribe button. If you don't, that's fine. I just appreciate you watching my video. I just appreciate you stopping by in general. Until next video, stay cool. But don't leave yet. I got something for you. If you're easily triggered, don't watch.
I wonder what I could make with this. Wait to get making.
In all seriousness, it is illegal to 3D print firearms and cats in the United States.
is make some napkin holders. And the first thing I want to do is make some so I found some napkin rings. Gobble, gobble!